Well, good afternoon. My name is Jen Dione, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Material Science and Engineering at Stanford University. In the brief time we have today, I'd like to introduce you to some new materials called upconverters that allow solar cells to see more light. As you may know, the sun provides more energy in 1 hour than the world consumes in an entire year. However, this energy is distributed across a broad electromagnetic spectrum. Approximately 5% of the sun's energy is in the ultraviolet, another 43% is in the visible, and 52% is in the infrared. Most solar cells today can only efficiently absorb photons up to visible or near-infrared frequencies. This means that anywhere between about 30 and 50% of the sun's energy cannot be absorbed by these solar cells. What my group is working on is a new technology called upconversion that can take the photons that otherwise would have been transmitted through a solar cell, combine them together to form a more energetic photon that then can be reabsorbed by the solar cell. This would allow approximately 70 to 100% of the solar spectrum to be utilized in photovoltaic cells. Unlike multi-junction technologies, this upconversion technology is not electrically connected to the solar cell. So it means that an upconverter can only improve the efficiency of the solar cell above it, and it can also be very cost-effective. In this slide, I show you the solar cell efficiency as a function of the solar cell bandgap, both with and without that upconverting layer placed behind the cell. And you'll see that without the upconverter, a solar cell is limited in efficiency to about 30%. But by adding the upconverter, we can increase that efficiency to over 44%. Our goal is to design an efficient, cost-effective upconverter. We do so by using solution-processed or colloidally processed materials, using a combination of earth-abundant molecular or ionic systems, in conjunction with metallic nanoparticles that allow us to precisely control photon molecule or photon ion interactions on these sub-wavelength scales. Then we can use a combination of either spin coating or spray casting to layer upconverting material over large areas on the back of our solar cell. To date, we've achieved excitation with a green handheld laser pointer that allows us to upconvert the green light to blue light. We can also excite just with a 120-watt lamp with energies comparable to the sun. Here, the lamp is just filtered in the green, and you can again see the upconversion to the blue. And now we're extending this technology to lamp excitation filtered in the infrared that allows us to get upconversion to the green. I want to emphasize that upconversion is not necessarily a new technology. In fact, it's been used for decades in the telecommunications industry. But historically, upconversion has only been achieved with very high-power laser sources. By combining novel photon absorbers that can efficiently absorb solar photons with metallic nanostructures, we can dramatically enhance the efficiency of upconversion to be able to achieve this process with solar photons. While a future challenge involves increasing the bandwidth of upconverter absorption to more efficiently absorb mid-infrared photons, hopefully I've shown you that upconversion can be an enabling process for future solar cell and solar fuel technologies. Thank you.